Salut à tous, c'est Dimitri Pike, Détroit Technomitia, Record 313. J'aimerais souhaiter un très joyeux anniversaire à In My House Radio Show et à Tina. Continuez d'écouter, continuez d'aider la techno de Détroit, mais surtout, continuez d'aimer la musique. Hi everyone, I'm Dimitri Pike, Detroit Technomitia, Record 313, and I would like to wish a very happy birthday to In My House Radio Show and Tina. Keep listening, keep supporting Detroit Techno, but at top of all, keep loving the music.
About that time for the house party. Are we ready, DJ Reggie Reg T to the M? Are we ready to throw down? We are? All right. Get your groove. Let's do you.
tell you real quick. I'm not your average kind of brother. I'm trying to be slick. I want something real, something my heart can feel. But you told me that you're gone again, you'll never reveal.
Is in my house tonight. Reggie Reggtm is in the house tonight. Wait a minute, I gotta bring the microphone over there. I know you don't like to talk, but I gotta do this anyway. Wait a minute. The house is hot. You sweating tonight. What's up, man? You sweating.
Well, check it. See, I was rushing trying to get here to get this set up. So, you know, but I knew I had a legend in the house. So I had to, this is one of my favorite tracks, man. This track is banging. This is one of my favorite tracks. So I had to, you know, I had to put it in there. I got another one that's sweet. That's sweet. That's by you. It's sweet. So I'm going to put it down. So it's an honor to be with this guy. It's an honor.
Let me do this commercial real quick. And then when I do this commercial real quick, you drop the track by Raybone. And then we're going to bring Raybone. How about that? Is that a good intro for you, Raybone? Is that going to work? The party. Wait a minute. What you say now?
I said, is that?
Look, y'all, January 18th, Martin Luther King weekend. If you don't know, hold on. You just don't know. You already know. All right. So we're going to do this quick commercial. Then you're going to introduce him real right. with some of his own, and then he gonna get on and take us out. How about that? Is that cool? All right.
I'm Wayne County Treasurer Eric Sabree. If you're facing tax foreclosure, you should have received a notice of a show cause hearing. These hearings are being held to advise you of all the options available to help you save your property. The hearing notices indicate an assigned date and time to attend. The hearings will be held during the month of January, beginning on January 10th, on the 8th floor of 400 Monroe in downtown Detroit. The show cause hearings are designed to help prevent foreclosure. I want you to keep your property, and we are here to help. In addition to our staff, there will be free financial counseling, legal services, and other public and private partners willing to assist you in avoiding property tax foreclosure. For more information, call 313-224-5990 or email us at taxinfo@waynecounty.com. If you have already entered into a payment plan or paid your 2014 and prior taxes in full, you do not have to attend. Please take advantage of this opportunity to avoid tax foreclosure.
All right, Reg, you ready to give Raybone the proper introduction? All right, let's see what you got. Raybone getting that proper intro. Already, what you think? Raybone, it's about that time. On the ones and twos, my man, my brother, always popping his head in the house. Raybone Jones. Let me say that right. DJ Raybone Show. Gotta give a real shout out to my man Charisma, Here and Now, featuring Osolade. Go ahead, Raybone. Woo hoo hoo. In My House Techno Music Show is about where the true stories are told and great music is played. And every once in a while, live instruments are definitely played. Shout out to Mark Charles bringing that flute. Here you go, Mark Charles on flute. In My House Techno Music Show, I'm your host, T. Carlita, celebrating 3 years. Thank you.
because you're dealing with a city that's full of people that are working, people that are struggling. You know, when it comes to the music, it's serious. Everybody here takes the music seriously.
Detroit as a city has got such a long musical history, jazz and blues and gospel music. That's amazing right there. But then, yeah, there's Motown. And when you look at something like Motown, a label that really changed the course of the music industry, I mean, the music world was never the same after Motown. I think that you've got some really strong roots you get to grow from. And this record is really where the word techno came from, where the word techno became widespread because of this record right here. Richie Houghton, you know, this guy was from just across the river here. He had a huge impact on what was happening within Detroit and what happened within the scene.
Techno, this is where it came from. It came from Detroit. So it's an underground sound. It's beating, it's working hard, and definitely hitting harder than anything else you've ever heard.
In the 80s, you had crack. A lot of things to really, you know, put people down spiritually. You know, this was about a future that was exciting, and it was an escape from whatever negativity was going on. This gear, this is what transformed everything. This gave people the ability to get out of their situation and get to that other future, that other reality. Thing of what underground resistance is. I mean, underground resistance has gone on for centuries, you know, thousands of years. There's an underground resistance, you know, across the globe. And this particular label and the guys involved in starting it up, Jeff Mills and Mike Banks, had both experienced some stuff which really put them in a position of having to deal with their own brand of resistance.
I'm Mad Mike, I'm 38, and you are founder, co-founder, me and Jeff Mills. I learned very early that fame and fortune was fleeting, and they only lasted as long as you had enough sense to keep it. And for many people, that wasn't long. I noticed that a lot of the people we had put out had stepped in front of their music in their effort to become famous. And when I saw how many of the black artists had became famous and got material shit and then f***ed it up, lost it all. What we look like really shouldn't make a big of a difference. Our thing was really, I'm nothing in comparison to the music. How can my face be more important than sound and the gift that sound brings to people?
You know, the first track on UR was called Your Time Is Up, with this woman named Yolanda on it, doing vocals, and Mike and Jeff Mills together had produced the track, and it was house. It was house music. What happens is later on, a more hardcore sound started to come out of UR. Then you have the whole Nation to Nation, World to World albums, later Galaxy to Galaxy, which has grown into Universe to Universe, the whole high-tech jazz sound. People always come by and ask, where's the UR studios? Well, there is no UR studio. What happens is each producer has their own studio. Everybody's responsible for really digging in and coming up with a sound that really defines what it is they're doing. You got a guy like Andre Holland, you got Billy Bob. What happens is on top of that, you've got the bands. You've got Interstellar Fugitives. You've got folks who have releases out proper. Folks like Mark Flash, Nomadico, DJ Scourge.
I never started listening to techno until probably the mid-90s. Because a lot of that music wasn't getting played on the radio, so you really had to go out to the clubs or the parties to really hear it. As I started asking around about the names, this UR label kept coming up.
UR is really something that people come to. And they've got something they're trying to express. They recognize that UR is a really strong vehicle for that.
I got hooked up with Underground Resistance through Deshaun Jones. He's the saxophone player, and me and him are the newest additions to Underground Resistance.
I didn't know what I was getting myself into, to be honest. because Cornelius came to me and said, you know, well, we pick up different saxophonists as we go along, and I'm thinking it's just a local band that does dates, but I had no idea that it was at this magnitude.
365 days ago, I never liked techno. I wasn't into it. I didn't understand why people enjoyed it so much, but I saw how energetic people were when they heard the music that we were performing, and I got to meet people, and they just described how techno has changed their lives. It was life-changing for me.
Mark Flash, UR078, DJ producer for Underground Resistance.
I'm a Nomadico, aka DJ Dex, UR061. I'm also a producer and tour DJ for Underground Resistance. I've been involved with Underground Resistance for actually 7 years now. My whole original intention of like working with these guys was because I kind of came from a similar background, you know, just like working class, but still interested in art and music and like basically expanding my horizons beyond like my neighborhood, which is what, when I came here, I found that these guys were really all about.
Most kids in my neighborhood never even get a chance to get out. They grow there. I've seen my friends that I grew up with, they're still there, still, you know, some of their parents haven't even left the neighborhood, don't even, like the mall, like, let's say a mall's in a different city. They haven't even been to the mall in another city. They shop in the same neighborhood, spend their money in the neighborhood, which is good, but you know, broaden your horizons, you know, see the world.
Let me see. I could actually, let me throw this on real quick. If there were no problems, you know, what type of music would have came out of the city? You know what I mean? If everything was, you know, suburban, you know, if this wasn't the place where that riots happened, it just wasn't a place where all those different civil rights issues went down.
The history of UR is important in that, you know, you need to understand that the history revolves around people who are fighting against stuff and trying to make things better and trying to find their voice. And so that's what this is about for me. This is about new dreams and being able to have new dreams and being able to go there and being able to say, look, you can have these dreams, and you know what? We're going to try to make those dreams real.
I think the real truth behind this music is we actually live this music. You know, this isn't a trivial thing. This is my life. This is John's life. And I depend on this. I depend on this to get me to where I need to be. So the music has a whole nother meaning because it's my life. And that's what Mike Banks has done for John and for myself. Because truthfully, just to call it for what it is, we're the future of this music. You know, we're like ambassadors, I guess, to the rest of the world of what it means to make this music and really make it happen.
I know for me as a musician, when I create something or play in front of people, the people give the energy. I can play better than I can normally. So truly, you have to ask the question, is it you playing the music or are you getting played?
Years later, I'm interviewing you now.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you know, you always had the spirit.
I thank you. And like I said, you know, this show is inspired and dedicated to Derek, and it's sad that, you know, he's no longer here. And I know that you had a very strong, unconditional relationship with him. And family is important to him. You know, our children, Jennifer and Derek, who are adults doing their own thing. Jennifer now got her own children, twins. And, you know, it's sad that, you know, Derek's not here to see it. And now that's why when this opportunity came to do the show, that's why I had to do this show. And my son, Lamar, you know, he comes, reads meter, and he talk about Uncle Mike is cool. Uncle Mike is cool. Love his stories. He keep it real. So just just briefly, you know, this is documenting history, and his children and now his granddaughters, they're going to see this show one day. Can Uncle Mike just tell them a little something about how Derek was when it came to his music and his love for his family?
He, oh man, that's a tough question. I think Jamerson was, yes, you know, sometimes being a genius can be a curse. And I think he was just so gifted at music. Me and my man was in there talking about it earlier. He was so gifted at music that sometimes he would lack in other areas in life, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And he loved all y'all. This is deep. We would talk about, you know, he had a particular problem he was dealing with.
Right.
And you know me, I couldn't give him nothing but the truth.
Mm-hmm.
And the truth was, you know, why don't you leave something your kids would be proud of? And he studied. He was kind of new to house music and all this type of stuff, but he studied and worked, and I mean, faster than anybody in the UR crew ever did. He came out with some bad stuff. I mean, his stuff was crushing, and you know, I would be coaching him, and I ain't expect to see him back for a month or 2 months or 3 months, and he'd be back the next day. You know, and he really just wanted to leave that music. I don't think he expected to check out as early as he did.
Right.
Nobody, I don't think any young person expects to check out, but in a strange way, he would always say, make sure my kids know I did focus and I did accomplish something. And he did. And I'm going to say this. Sometime in a musician's life, their creation, it's kind of like where we had a mask on. Right. You know, his music was from God, and anything from God is greater than the person that made it.
Welcome to another episode of the In My House Techno Music Show. This is T. Carlita. I am behind the camera because I am officially out the house on a lovely afternoon somewhere in Detroit, hanging out with the one and only soulful, velvety, chocolate, smooth as hell voice. And you know we love our cars in the D. My man, Bill Beaver. What up, man?
We cruising, T. What is happening?
Yay.
Good to be here. Happy to see everyone.
We finally got together.
Wow. Yeah.
So today, we're inspired by car stars and a lot of electronics.
Yeah.
let's just go back a little bit. I brought some inspiration today. And you informed me that Mr. Stevie Anderson did a very good job at finding the original remix, correct?
Mr. Stevie Anderson.
All right. This, so let's talk about that.
Yeah. Actually, I don't think it quite was a remix. I guess you could technically say that, but this was the European version, if you will, for True Love Records.
Okay.
Yeah. And we did a domestic side, and this was the European side. It got released close to around the same time. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now let's talk about the artwork. We had a conversation off camera about the artwork. So
Keith Haring, the infamous Keith Haring. This was some of the early stuff that he made when I caught wind in London and hanging out in Brixton and stuff in 1992. And then we came across Keith Haring.
Wow.
With John Trulove and the guys and React Records. Shouts out to you guys.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let's talk about Members of the House. They was composed
members
of who?
The house. Oh my God, it's so many members to the house.
Okay. Were there a core group or just...
Yeah, it was an entourage.
Okay.
And different, you know, because when you talk about, you know, Mike Banks and Jeff Mills and those guys and on Santa Barbara and back on 7 Mile back in the day, what really happened was it was a changeover from close to maybe like... you know, when the Detroit compilation, the techno compilation first came out?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was Crystal Gaynor was doing Let Me Share My House.
Oh,
but
wow.
It was so many variations of sounds that came from the quote-unquote group Members of the House.
Mm-hmm.
It was Mike Harris. It was Nico Marx. It was Gerald Mitchell was part of some of that stuff. It was, oh, God, it was Avery Midnight. You
wow.
know, all those cats, you know, we had a lot of fun. And so, then members of and then it turned into a 4-man group, a stand-up group, which that's where this comes into play.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Okay, so you have you don't have to hold that forever. I'll take that.
I was gonna give it a kiss.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
There you go. Hey, that's awesome. So, you know, I know you have now I'm gonna go back to the first time that I physically met you.
Okay.
And it was at Los Hermanos record release party, I believe. I know I saw you on the
many
dance floor.
Many years before I met you.
Yeah.
But I was doing a magazine. That's another story. But
okay, right. But I have seen you on the dance floor several times. I have pictures of you. Actually, we were at Bruce Bailey and Nim's Prelude, and you had those glow-in-the-dark beads around your neck or something. That's pretty cool. But the first time I actually got a chance to see the performer, not the dancer, was I think it was at either a house gallery or it was at Los. I know it was Motor City Wine. I don't know what event, but I know it was. And you were playing this horn of a thing, and it was like super long.
Oh,
or a drumstick or something. And what is that called?
It was a didgeridoo from Australia.
Wow.
Yeah. The Aborigines gave me that didgeridoo.
Okay,
and
so
I kept it in my entourage.
Wow. So you have a wide range of vocal talent and vocal skills. So how would you best describe your vocals? You know, people say alto, sax, baritone, blah, blah. So
I can explain it to is like the stuff me and Gerald are working on now. You know, we were just talking about it the other day. I get into characters, you know. So if I get into the character and... it entails that I may have to sound like a Ron Banks or a Philip Bailey, or I get into a character where it may have to sound like a Curtis Mayfield or some of the guys from the Dramatics, or from a vocal thing, you know, from a heritage, old school vocal type thing. I draw from different artists, you know, and just, that's it.
So I take it those few that you named have been some of the inspirations for you,
definitely.
I would assume.
And it just don't stop. You know, I have a mental, like for instance, I was talking about this the other day. You know, when DJs do remixes, they do music remixes, right?
Mm-hmm.
In my mind, I do vocal remixes. So
okay.
I'll go channel into Stevie Wonder or Donny Hathaway. It just depends on what we're working on.
So channel into one of those voices. Go into your teleportal prompter. Close your eyes. What you got? Give us some. Right now, off the cuff, unscripted. Let's go.
Like, you know, now that's on the spot. But okay.
You know that's what
so
we do.
So be it.
I knew you were ready.
But what do we do? I mean, I don't know. When your mother gave birth to you and you came on earth, and then you want to find something special and why you're here, makes you want to say, oh Lord, I'm here on earth, so let's get down, babe.
See? I love Detroit. We always ready. That was your audition.
We're gonna actually play you from some of that piece, that montage that I was working. We're gonna play you something.
Shoot. I know Gerald is hanging in the wings. Gerald is in the wings. I appreciate it. Hey, we in the studio. What's the official name? Everybody's studio has a name. What does Gerald call this place?
He called this the infamous Barcelona Room.
All right. So we're hanging out.
Barcelona Room.
So, Bill, let's see. You're known for trees.
That too.
Not those trees, but those trees too.
Well, yeah.
You're the tree man.
Well, now, I have a small company, Eager Beaver Tree Services. We are eager to be a beaver and take that tree off of your house.
And see, y'all get y'all minds out of them papers. Because
you know my last name is Beaver, but a lot of people know me as Billy Love Detroit. Billy Love Trees. Billy Love Music.
Oh, yeah, Billy Love. Tell me about that. Where'd that come from?
Well, that story derives from my name, Billy Logan, William Logan Beaver. Oh. Billy is short for William or Willie or Will. So it's Billy, and then it started out actually Billy Lowe. So I made some records with Theo Parishinum and all them, and Rick and all those guys, and it was Billy Lowe, the three chairs and all that.
Okay.
Billy Lowe. And then I had a problem with the Chinese guys taking the name and taking the music saying it's theirs. I guess how YouTube done everything. So I said, well, wait a minute now, My last name is Logan. So I said, okay. In New York, I was Billy Logan. When the music and the independent music part came around, I turned in from Billy Lowe. So I said, it's L-O, so it's short for V-E. Because all my friends were growing up, they would say, hey, we all called each other Lowe. Like, it was like Julo, Bill Lowe. It was short for love, So it was a childhood thing. It kind of stuck and... So, when the business part kicked in, it went from Billy Lowe to Billy Love, Detroit.
Okay.
And so I made a string of music bigging up Detroit. When nobody would big it up, you know how it is when you're hanging in the alleys and you're singing doo-wopping and hearing all the tracks being made all over the city, through the years and the decades. So it's just like I spent a lot of time around Detroit for a lot of reasons, with all the circles, that kind of thing.
Okay.
Loving our culture.
So, you are... very talented as a vocalist, and today we have vocals and singers.
Yeah.
So what do you think is missing in some of the vocal talents that exist compared to what we have? I mean, you name like a whole wealth of names in just a quick short second. You can barely do that now. So what's the difference now then, and what's missing, and what's up?
I think
with that?
Somebody said it before. They were saying back in, I wouldn't go to music class, but a lot of cats I know, the respect that Jerome and everybody probably went to music class, but I always showed up at the talent show. And I had my own, I come from a musical background, a family of musicians, so we practice all the time, that kind of thing at home. But I would say if you grew up in a family with musicians, cultivate the family, cultivate all the children that you see, keep it in the household, have talent shows. I believe that wholesome thing will keep anybody pretty rounded.
That information about, the Billy, the Low, the Love, and how it all came about. And I mean, whenever I did see you out and about, you always was this bubbly, happy soul and happy spirit. So that's I always remember that. So love wouldn't be that complicated. And
well, yeah,
I can dig it.
Detroit.
So you are born, bred, raised.
Born and raised in Detroit City.
All right.
Yeah.
So we are in the Barcelona Room.
Barcelona Room.
Is there anything that you would like to talk to or speak to as far as up-and-coming vocalists or people that are in their own rooms
and maybe
don't know how to or scared to? Give them some food for thought.
Well, I could share this with you, what got me out of my rut when I was younger, I used to ride on the bus and say, hey, techno started down here near the Eastern Market, but I was, singing, ballads and stuff, and when I would hear, when Juan would hit the radio back in the day and all that, you hear all these different kind of tones and voices and gimmicky sounds, whatever, from, you got formal training, don't be afraid to cross the line and do some Parliament Funkadelic geeky sounds, or you never know how stuff fit in, because breathing techniques will get you there, know, breathing techniques will get you there. Let's say you did 100 of those. You know, by the time you calm down, you were able to do some scales that you never thought you could do. It's just so many techniques that you can apply. I guess that's what I'm really trying to say. I tried a million techniques to just come up with a bunch of things in my mental toolbox or artistic toolbox that I can draw from depending on what I'm working on at the time. Start you an artistic toolbox.
Artistic.
Some kind of toolbox that you can draw from and tap into whatever it is that you're working on. Whether it's vocals or illustrations or whatever you have. It's just art doesn't just come one way. You know, it comes in many ways. So.
That kind of answers the question I was going to think in my head to ask you. Like, when you, I asked the DJs, like, what's in the mind of the DJ when you're preparing for a gig? So, for you, what's in the mind of Billy Love when you're preparing to present yourself?
It goes back, like me and Drew was talking about this, being able to channel, you know, channel into all of the cool things you ever had that gave you great joy in your life, you know. And if it's talking about through a music thing, you know, my dad was a DJ in the 70s, you know, UBQ and the Blue Chateau and all that. And I was the son of a DJ, so I used to play with the records. And he would discipline us, put all the records in the sleeve. And I would study the records, and I can't wait to be grown. I'm going to have me this and a car like that and this and that, whatever. So my imagination took the best of me, and I just channeled and followed my dreams. You know, if I could say it, it's all kind of cliche, whatever, but dig back into your inner you and stick to the stuff you loved as a kid, and you're still the same person alive. Bring it home. Bring it on in. And then push it on out, you know, that kind of thing. If I can say it like that. You know.
Got you. So let's go to Europe.
Europe.
Now, you know, brother from the hood, 7 mile east, west, all over all the best. That first mine and that first experience, what was going through your head when they said, hey, we're going to Europe?
Totally overwhelmed. Totally overwhelmed.
You remember it?
Yeah, I remember it.
Like yesterday?
Like yesterday, you know. Totally overwhelmed.
Okay.
Yeah, it was what to expect. Are we going to be able to eat? Will we like the food? You know, all that.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, and we did about what 56 gigs in a month. I mean, what is that? 5 gigs a night and TV shows, and we were breaking open, quote unquote, techno. I guess it really wasn't a big name at the time. It was progressive music, and we were just trying to blend. Well, we were talking about this the other day again.
You guys talk about a lot of stuff back the other then, day.
Back then, all of the radio station played everything. So we had every genre of music meshing it in. Like now, it seems like everything's so tight-knit. Mm-hmm. But back then, you could put the Pesh Mode in with David Bowie mixed with Parliament Funkadelic and Kraftwerk and everybody. It all worked together. So going over there, you know, we tried a little bit of everything, you know. And when we started going into Motown, that's when we got all the love in a techno gig.
Really?
We did all this other stuff, house music stuff. It didn't fly. It was like, what are they doing? Next thing you know, we did...
Marvin Gaye was on.
No,
huh?
We did Ball of Confusion.
Oh.
No, it was Cloud Nine by The Temptations, and Jeff and Mike did a techno mix. It never came out, but for the show, we ran that, and that's when we had them.
Wow.
Yeah, we knew that was our secret weapon, and it worked all the way through. Ain't that something?
Motown, I'm telling you, it's legacy.
Motown remixed on some straight-up beat-you-over-the-head, four to the flow techno.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so 1991, 92, 91, all that. 92. Yeah.
Okay. So we're in this Barcelona room, and, you know, I want to make sure that we talk to the man of the house.
That's right.
I guess one of the members of the house.
Man in the house. Member in the house.
Yay.
So we're in his house.
We're in his house. So we're going to take a break.
Okay.
Take a quick commercial spot, pause for the cause, as they
pause
say.
For the cause.
And when we get back, we're going to go one on two with you and he in the Barcelona room we be.
Hey, when we get back to the Barcelona room, we're going to give you the phrase that pays. Has something to do with summertime fun.
Yeah.
I'm Wayne County Treasurer Eric Sabree. If you're facing tax foreclosure, you should have received a notice of a show cause hearing. These hearings are being held to advise you of all the options available to help you save your property. The hearing notices indicate an assigned date and time to attend. The hearings will be held during the month of January, beginning on January 10th, on the 8th floor of 400 Monroe in downtown Detroit. The show cause hearings are designed to help prevent foreclosure. I want you to keep your property, and we are here to help. In addition to our staff, there will be free financial counseling, legal services, and other public and private partners willing to assist you in avoiding property tax foreclosure. For more information, call 313 224-5990 or email us at textinfo@waynecounty.com. If you have already entered into a payment plan or paid your 2014 and prior taxes in full, you do not have to attend. Please take advantage of this opportunity to avoid tax foreclosure.
Back in the Barcelona studio. It's just me and two guys hanging out now. So the owner of this lovely establishment is in this screen right now.
What up? How y'all doing tonight?
So Gerald Mitchell, it has been a long time since you've been on the show. Actually, you know, this is the third year. And you were there probably within the first 4 or 5 weeks of the brand, when I first started. You and Los Hermanos, shout out to the painter and all the other guys.
Right.
But we tried to put a little more light on the subject this time because y'all's interview was totally in the dark. Sorry.
Yeah, well.
Oh, man.
But, you know, I'm used to that from, you know, the previous group I was with.
All right.
Still am affiliated with.
Okay. So we are joined together here today to get through this thing called life. No, I'm just kidding. That purple shirt is inspiring me there, Billy.
Oh, you're reading my life.
So what's up, guys? What y'all got going on?
What's happening?
Well, yeah. I just want to put some light on the subject and, you know, let's talk about nutrition. Let's talk about food. Food for the soul, food for the mind, food for the family, food, you know.
Food sounds good.
Yeah.
And you need some good food, like some salad.
Yeah.
You need your greens. Got to get some meat, some greens. Don't eat all the meat all the
time. Fiber.
Meat is good sometimes, I believe, for some people, but, you know, some people don't do it meat, but... Get you some
fiber, you know, and the thing is, if you can translate that from, and I'm sure you agree with this, we can translate food for the mind, food for the body, food for the soul.
Yes, sir.
You know, food for your ear.
Well, I tell you, dietary needs are very important because as men, I have to say I'm over blah 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 years old, but I've had a recent colonoscopy check.
Oh boy,
that's how many guys have the colonoscopy? I came out to be clear. Everything's clear. They didn't find anything. But now that I know this. You know, I got to, you know, still change my dietary needs, but I'm just thankful to be healthy.
Wait a minute,
You guys got to go get checked if you haven't got to get checked.
Are you saying that your health is your wealth?
Your health is your wealth,
It's your wealth, baby.
You know what I'm saying? That's a gift we got here, so we got to use the gift as long as possible. Mm-hmm. And I just want to put my verse in the world, which is part of the music.
Yeah.
We add our verses to this, you know, thing called life.
Yeah.
And which
brings us to some of these titles that we've been working on, a body of music.
Right.
And which brings it... as it relates to food of the mind, body, and soul. So as it relates to music. So
you guys been knowing each other for how long?
150 years.
At least.
We've known each other. We've been around each other, heard about each other.
Yeah.
Like I remember
from teenagers on up.
I think it was basically during the connection of...
Battle of the Band days, 1982.
Yeah, we were Lamborghini. What group was
Lamborghini.
Yeah, my name of my group was Lamborghini.
I was with Kiera.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
And then all of the bands started.
So anyway, we came together and we decided to do music. We hadn't done music in a while.
Okay.
So we decided to do, I contacted Bill. And we started talking and doing...
He was in Japan. It's like, Bill, I didn't know you did all this stuff.
Oh, man. Let me tell you the story right quick.
Yes,
so
please.
We do this track called Private Party, which is out on Descendants of the Resistance. And me and Bill did a track. And so I had to call him back from Japan asking for his publisher. So when I looked up his discogs and saw all he was involved with, I'm like, dude. I called him from Japan like, dude. What? It was like, hey, man. So, you know, once we got all that out the way, I said, I got to work with this cat. He's somebody everybody overlooking. They don't understand. But you hear his voice everywhere, but you don't know who he is.
Well, I got 150 pseudonames.
Dude, anyway. I called Bill, came back home. Hey, man, let's do some music. We kind of found some similar interests, you know, as far as the music really.
We said, let's go back to the good, feel good music when it was fun in those eras.
The old funk, 1970s, 80s, 90s, you know,
Came through.
Right. Like the other day, we were talking about New Wave. How many people do New Wave so far? Nope. We working on one.
Nouveau, Nouveau.
Oh, that's awesome.
Oh, don't worry about
it. So before we get into your oh my God, you take I'm about to put on my big hair.
We were at a party.
I knew this was gonna be fun. Okay. So before we really get into what you guys are working on currently, you know, Gerald, you and I have been communicating even before the show and before you came on the show via social media, yes. Facebook Messenger.
Yes.
And the moment you went to Japan and you connected with Jeff Mills, and that's something that I really been wanting to get you on here, and I'm going to zoom in on you real quick. And tell me, you know, we all know who Jeff Mills is, the wizard, the whole nine yards. But when you got that call, or when you got the, how did that happen exactly?
I think it was an evolution of meeting and knowing Jeff. First of all, I have to say Jeff is one of my techno heroes, and just knowing him through Underground Resistance and through everybody like Mike Banks and everything, and just coming across a lot of times him. I guess he looked and saw what I was doing, and you know, I got a call from actually his wife, and she called me, and Jeff was interested in putting a band together. And at first, I don't think we really had a name, but right now it's called Spiral Deluxe. Get that thing over there. Yeah, it's a band called Spiral Deluxe. Matter of fact, we'll be on tour this May again. So he wanted me to be the keyboard player, and he had this vision of just doing other type of music, like fusion and keeping it real and just kind of much just improvising over some of the beats he would lay out. You know, he wanted you to be all organic and do what you feel. That's what I like about the band. So he got two other players together, which is Mr. Gino on bass. He's very good Japanese bass player. And then we have Yumiko, who's a synthesizer player, plays with Buffalo Daughter. Of course, Jeff, who's, you know, who, you know, Jeff Mills is, the wizard, a la Jeff Mills. Then you got me, Gerald Mitchell, you know, Los Hermanos. So that was a great combination. So when he called me, I already knew, like, wow, this is a great combination he's putting together. And, I, you know, I just went forth with his vision, and I had much fun.
Okay. So the first time you guys stepped on the stage together and they announced the group, or and they did it in the language, and you are like standing by behind your keyboard getting ready to hit that first chord, tell me about the feeling that you got at that first moment.
Well, I know I get that feeling every moment. It doesn't matter how big the crowd is or how small the crowd is. But just right now, I get this feeling like, wow, you know, I see codes, I see patterns, I see different things, you know. The creators have blessed me to see these patterns and codes over there. So I use them, even with the electronics part of it. So I'm always feeling really just like adventurous, excited, and at the same time, I'm on a mission, you know what I mean? It's to make the best music that I can, you know what I'm saying? So on stage, you know, it's the same way. I feel that same way. So it doesn't matter how big or large the crowd. Although I must say I get a lot of energy from a lot of people who's enthused about the music and everything. I really do like the great feedback, you know what I'm saying? So that motivates me as well, too, to do music.
And I remember you had sent me a message after one of the gigs. I don't know which show it was exactly. And we had a conversation about timeline. And I remember you telling a story when you were on the show before about Derek Jamerson Sr. I have to put the senior there now. Mm-hmm. When he did timeline. And yeah. It was on one of your keyboards. And he came in, did it so fast and so quick. And now that's a timeline synonymous to like a never-ending timeline. Yeah. And you guys did that. And I appreciate you for even sharing the response that it got. So when you guys did timeline, what was it like?
I have to be honest, I was just around because I was working at General Motors at the time, so I worked afternoon, so you know, I had left the keyboard there, and then Mike and Derek worked on it. When I came back, Mike had this track, and I'm like, man, you guys is just killing it. So for me, it was just the energy of the other producers that motivated me to become a producer too. You know, like Suburban Night, James Pennington would come from a gig, or Rolando would come from a gig, after doing some missions for Underground Resistance, you know, hanging out with Mike in the studio, hanging out with different people, seeing Juan in the building, seeing Terrence Dixon in the building. You know, all this, that building at 2030 motivated 2030. Me to good do. God, it was just, I mean, I went in there with like, hey, these cats are good. I ain't messing around either. So, you know, I had to come with my A game.
Wow.
So that energy of producers created what you see now and what you hear.
All right. Yeah. So now let's fast forward to now. Huge. You two guys. So what's the project? Give us the exclusive scoop. What's the project's guy? What's the project guy? What is it?
Well, listen, I'll let Mr.
Oh, I knew he's gonna say
this
that.
Is your man G Mitchell Los Hermanos networking right
G-107.5.
Now.
G107.5.
We got B107.5.
What's that 107.5 about?
We're the 107.5.
Well, see, that's the frequency we on, you
that's
know.
The frequency
everybody on. In Detroit know about that yeah. frequency, you know.
Oh yeah.
So but yeah, it was a project, like I said, I came home from overseas, me and Bill was in the car. We did a lot of little videos yeah. on Facebook and stuff. And,
yeah, backyard series, backseat series.
Yeah, backseat series. We had some celebrities and stuff. So we just kept talking amongst ourselves, and we finally just did. I was like, hey, Bill, it's time enough talking. We came up with this.
Yeah, I mean, after you, we call it the backyard boogie. Like, when we come together, I build a stage in my backyard, right? And I'm a tree cutter, right? So I'm burning firewood, and we're just gelling. It's any season, all season, all
playing music
season.
Outside, playing outdoors, music, you know what I'm saying?
And we're just chopping it up and thinking things over, and then these concepts start coming out. But I have marimbas on this stage, so I can play, and I got drums and stuff and hanging around, and I'll bring a keyboard out, and so we can talk and play and mesh. So it's kind of like that. And we had our own barbecues, you know? Yeah, and so.
So I had a couple tracks. Bill came over a couple times, and you know, we just work and gel really quick together. You know, I pretty much like Bill to just be himself, you know what I'm saying? And then I just have these tracks.
Would he be anything else but that, actually?
Yeah.
It took a long time to get here. I am pretty much this.
I have to say this. A lot of people ask me, hey, how do you get Bill in the studio? How can you deal with... But, you know, me and Bill, you know, I think we crossed one time in the studio, right?
Yeah.
Bill's like, hey, G, you got to see the way I record. And I understand. I step back. I said, okay, you just got to let this guy do his thing. So I just gave him tracks.
He tells me, I say, Gerald, there's no possible way I could do this session. Like, Bill, let's just see what happens. And I was beat down to the ground. Next thing you know, that's the best performance. So see how it goes? It's like,
yeah, so
meeting of the minds. So.
I mean, yeah, and it just come, the songs come really quick. So we got like about 5 or 6, 7 yep. songs right about now. Yeah. And it's like we're trying to create that 80s, 70s, or any type of vibe. Like I say, even some new
we're
way.
Drawing from all the elements. Yeah.
And it's just not a cut, copy, paste. Can I say that again?
Yeah, that's right.
What is it? What do you call it?
Hit. Cut, copy, paste. For something in the future.
So we're playing everything down, you know, bouncing. We're going back to the old way.
We're doing it the old way of recording. Yeah.
Every chorus and verse is a different nuance in the instrument. Actually, we're going to start adding... drummers and horn players.
Yeah, some of our keen, cool folks around the country getting down.
Yeah.
So. Lucille Gabriel, Gabe Gonzalez on drums.
He's
Gabriel
awesome.
on guitar.
You got Piranha Head on the tape.
Derek James coming in.
A lot of Detroit talent, a lot of Detroit musicians.
And here's another thing to say. Between us all, we've all been in the same bands or derivatives of the same band over the last 30 years.
That's
30
awesome.
Plus years.
Wow.
So it's a fabric of a sound.
Yeah, and we're pretty
and
much...
And it's missing. That's why we're bringing it back.
And we're pretty much taken from a lot of our heroes, like Parliament, Funkadelic, Ohio Players. We're channeling all them people. In, like, Bernie is gone. I try to channel Bernie a little bit. I try to channel anything that I hear, even some jazz stuff, you try to channel and add all that. Just make it one big... pot of from instruments
some
and
techno gumbo
musicians that we have learned from coming up,
and you know it's going to be spicy because he loves spicy food, right?
Spicy food.
You know, we got a little bit for everybody. We got some spicy, some mellow, some mild.
Yeah, we have some mild.
We got some
too,
for the children.
Yeah, and it's one track we got is called Celebrity Barbecue Sauce.
Celebrity Barbecue Sauce. Let's start there.
Yeah,
let's talk about that.
That's the first one. Bill came over. He brought a friend over, and we were just talking, like we're talking in the studio now. And I had this groove up. I say, Bill, I got this groove, and what you think about it, right? So he started talking, and then, you know, Bill talked. Next thing you know, he's talking barbecue sauce. And I heard this pattern he did. I go, barbecue, celebrity barbecue, that barbecue sauce. Yeah. So I heard that. I'm like, well, that was the hook, you know what I'm saying?
And he then, said, that's the hook. I said, well, let's take it from there.
So it was like 1 minute. We were just going to do like a little...
A jingle,
a commercial, because...
It was only 30 seconds long.
Yeah, I got inspired. I have a cousin who has her own garden in Chicago of hot... jalapeno peppers and stuff, and she makes her own. She made her own sauce and she sells it. And me and Bill was tasting it, so I guess maybe that's.
And then we started singing some more and dipping the chips in the sauce, and we just started rolling it out.
So Bill heard, he was like, "Gee, you need to make that a song." So we turned it into an eight minute track, right?
It's about 8 minutes now.
Wrote a song about it. Want to hear it?
Want to hear it? That's right. And we made it because all our friends should come around, and you know how it gets when you start riding down the street and you smell some smoke, somebody banging good in that barbecue grill, and you're like, "Who's doing that?" Next thing you know, you get closer and closer. The next thing you know, you see the people sitting around and bringing everything and putting it on the table. And you got coleslaw, potato salad, greens. And it's a thing. It's a backyard boogie. That's what we call it, a backyard boogie. And we might write a song that on the same.
And basically, we are researching and putting that sauce together to make the celebrity barbecue.
In case some folks want to taste
the real celebrity, we want to really get into the barbecue sauce business.
That is so cool.
And we need taste testers, so come on
back. And some celebrities come on back.
With every sale, you get a sale. Sample sauce mixer, and you're gonna make them do the little taste
the lyrics to the song. Check out the lyrics. You may get your clue to the next celebrity barbecue.
Oh, this is like Willy Wonka, the golden ticket. The ticket to the next.
We put clues inside the song.
That is so awesome. So, you know, we are inside of the Barcelona studio. And, you know, people overseas, and shout out to the over 70 countries, by the grace of God, over my 3 years, have been tuning in, and the reception has just been amazing. And, you know, they love, like, anything Detroit does, pretty much. But what fascinates them more so is to see you guys in action, hear the stories, see you in action. So I want to just kind of like at a low volume, let's give the world just a little sample of what it's like to be in the just off the cuff Barcelona studio with these two real live from the real Detroit people.
Yeah, well,
homegrown talent. So let's fire up the gear.
Anyway, so basically what we do is I'll play or have a groove for Bill, you know what I mean? But in this case, this groove was a little different, which is barbecue. Which one you wanna do, man?
Barbecue.
Well, say for instance, I'm doing this one, okay. So this is how we kinda gel together. Bill, I got this track. Check it out. You ready?
Yeah. Gerald, be on the keys, playing that sound.
doing, so I would. But I don't know how.
But anyway, that rhythm and song is to a whole different track.
Yeah, we match.
But Bill and I, we just vibe like that. That's how we do it. So
yeah. Wow. It's always a master mix.
Yay! Well, I appreciate you inviting me in the studio today. We got it done. It's all good.
I'm so happy. I want to say special congratulations to the birthday of Mac and House. So happy that you guys are here to do this kind of stuff because we need more of that. I mean,
hey, it's the third year. I didn't think I would be doing this long.
Hey, the third turn into 30 or 300 or 3,000 or infinite.
I appreciate that, guys.
That's right.
Take us out on a little tracks, guys. Let's go to the commercial. Take us out.
Take us out.
Is this live or you need something from the computer? You need live, right?
Go for it.
Let's do it live, Bill.
Come on.
Let's see what we got. All right, Bill. We're going to do some kind of funky. All right, here you go.
Funky.
We on it.
Give it to me. We don't need no sound. I wear about the wind. We don't need no set. I wear about the wind. Roll it up in the green leaf. In a switch, you get kind of lit. Get funky, yeah. I'll show you how to have that. Oh, we don't need no sound. Oh, we want to win. We don't want no sleep. Oh, we want to green. Roll it up in the green leaf. What switch you get kind of lit? Show that finger style is better than mine. The same thing. Oh, you killed me.
Alright, that's it.
These past 3 years, putting together the In My House Techno Music Show has been quite an experience. It's been exciting, challenging. A learning experience. It's really sharpened my skills as far as music is related and really got a good understanding of producing. Producing, I guess you can say. I really appreciate and admire everyone who puts music together and produces their music and produces their mixes. Putting the show together really gave me a greater appreciation for what everyone does in this business. And for those that have been doing it for so many years, I commend you and I pray and I hope that you all continue to create great music and continue to have those true stories to tell. I appreciate everyone who supported the show over these past 3 years. And thank you for tuning in and watching this 2-hour special, my party away from the party, I guess you can say. But throughout my show, there's been some really cool video, you know, searching for visual has been interesting as well. And I came across a video by Appollonia called The Banshees or The Benshee. And I think it's just really cool the way they took like Muppet characters and created this video. So I'm going to share that again with you in this anniversary celebration show, followed by the Spirit of 313 mix. And then that's going to take us out. But before that, I have some very special words from a very dear person who has been a really good friend, a good fan, a good follower and appreciator of the In My House Techno Music Show, Mr. Stevie Anderson over in the UK, who was truly a definite Spirit of 313 brother. So here is The Benshees, followed by Spirit of 313 mix, put together by John Do It Easley and inspired by Stevie Anderson over in the UK. This is T. Carlita for the In My House Techno Music Show, where the true stories are told
and great music is played. The beginning of the show, I received an email from a gentleman over in the UK. It was actually the very first email that I received from him, and we have connected so much on a hashtag or a spirit of 313 level. It was July 12th, 2014. And I received this email from this gentleman from the UK.
and it was tagged as "Is House Spiritual Music?" And the email read as follows: "Hi T Carlita, I recently watched one of your archive shows featuring Ron Spears. What a humble and gifted person. Listening to his spoken verse recited on your show reminded me that the music we love is deeply spiritual. Here is a scripture from the Bible to support my view," which is his view. "Praise him with drums and dancing. Praise him with harps and flutes. Praise him with cymbals. Praise him with loud cymbals. Praise the Lord. Psalms 150, verse 4 through 6. Keep up the wonderful work you do. Stevie." That was one of many emails that he and I have exchanged. And he has also blessed me with several what we like to call royal mail packages. And it's just a wonderful thing. I appreciate you, Stevie Anderson. And that is why you are definitely the In My House historian on many levels. I truly appreciate you, and I truly appreciate you continually inspiring me through email and keeping in touch. So let me just play that piece from Ron Spears when he did his spoken word piece. And I hope you enjoyed it. Enjoy it as much as Stevie did. This is T. Carlita for the In My House Techno Music Show. Here's Ron Spears. Music in the backdrop here.
All right. So while you're setting that up, I'll set up this piece I'm going to do. This is a piece that I did actually during the Movement House Music Festival in Detroit. Earl McKinney had, he asked me to introduce him or to do a spoken word intro to his DJ set during the Movement Festival downtown 2 years ago. Two summers ago. And so I wrote this piece that kind of talks a little bit about Africa and brings the history of house music.
All right, here we go.
You ready?
Ready. Go ahead, Ron. It's on you now.
All right. "When God created the original people, he gave them the African drum. When the Africans started to beat that drum, he had no idea what was to come. From the union of the African and his drum came a mighty rhythm and tone that communicated messages that unite people and put them in a spiritual zone. The power of that drum spread throughout the entire continent for hundreds of years, connecting all African heart people to one single heartbeat manifesting through their ears. Forced through the Middle Passage and scattered throughout the Western Hemisphere, we lost our traditions, our culture, and our connection as a people, making our survival unclear. Oh, but the Creator was wiser than us. Little did we know that our reawakening would soon come. The common bond and unifying force in us can be traced back to that African drum. The unity that we are experiencing right now in Detroit can be found in the movement of our feet. Our love for house music can explain by breaking down the anatomy of the beat. The kick drum provides the low sound, the high, hot, high, and the snare down the middle. The soulful hand claps and the bongos add rhythm to the keyboards and strings just a little. But when the DJ plays that bass line, it's all over. It resonates with our mind, body, and spirit. The sultry vocal tracks call and the people respond as soon as they hear it. You see, house music for those who believe is just as powerful as any religion. The right DJs are like ministers and the spoken word has always been our tradition." It goes on like that, but you know, I kind of talk about that piece in the Movement video as well, just talking about the love affair with house music and how it can transform our lives.
Can all relate? We must stop fighting to achieve the peace that was taught in our country. We shall all be free.
thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Imagine the lights and the lights and the lights and the flick of God's switch. All the lights and the lights and the lights. Yeah, you can run, but you can't hide. Cause if we don't change quick, it's coming. A world eclipse. Blackout.
The lights,
in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the spirits of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. The beginning and the ending. Do you believe? For God so loved the earth that he gave his only son. Are you listening?
The lights come on. The lights go on. Blackout.
And I beheld where he opened a sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood, and the stars of heaven fell unto the earth, even as a fig tree casts her untimely figs, when she is shaken of a mighty wind, and the heaven departed as a scroll, when it is rolled together, and every mountain and island were moved out of their place. Think about it. If the Lord built the world in just 6 days, how long do you think it would take him to demolish it?
The lights come on, the lights go on. Blackout at the flick of God's switch.
Unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. O my God, I trust in thee. Let me not be shamed. Let not mine enemies triumph over me. He is the light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? He is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? But fear not, after the blackout, the meek and humble shall inherit the earth. The question is, are you meek and humble?
The lights come on, the lights go on.
Do you know the Ten Commandments? Read Exodus quick, learn, cause it is coming.
Blackout at the flick of God's switch.
Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Imagine this, the lights in the universe are all on, and at the flick of God's switch, all the lights in the world are out. Yeah, you can run, but you can't hide, cause if we don't change quick, it's coming, a world eclipse, blackout.